night. Saturday night. Saturday night.
Saturday night.
You reckon they're still open?
Saturday night.
They're all gone.
Oh yeah, they're definitely closed. Just very curious. Coke signs just behind me, and in a nutshell, I guess, you know, a lot of this area has changed in the last probably 70, 80 years. It did start out as a bohemian sort of place. A lot of intellectuals and artists sort of made it their home. Lots of changes over the years. Now, obviously, before 2014, when the lockout laws were introduced, King's Cross kind of had a reputation as a seedy, you know, not a really safe place to go out. However, lots of clubs here thrived from, you know, the dance clubs like Sugar Reef, places like that, to the hard rock venues like the Kardomah and Springfields, Manzil Room. So today we're actually going to go and have a look and see where the old Manzil Room is, what it looks like, where the old Kardomah Club was. And yeah, just check it out. You just find Bayswater Road, and it's only a couple of hundred metres up. Well, this is where the old Kardomah was. So here it is, the old Kardomah.
You can buy it.
It's actually for lease.
There you go. Why don't you open up your own club?
Office suites available. My memory of it is it was really dark. You go down those stairs. It was pretty much like a brick sort of alcoves and brick everywhere inside. And it was just really dark. So yeah, it looks like it's sort of nothing.
Was it just someone's house?
Maybe. And right next door there was a place called Sugar Reef. Many a time I remember, you know, walking in with like the leather mini skirt and the, you know, big rock and roll kind of outfit, and then you'd sort of look across and you'd have these dance club people in their really nice, you know, well-groomed outfits, listening and dancing to that kind of, you know,
what did that turn into?
Doof doof type music, I guess. I don't know, this looks like it's it's a training place now. I'm pretty sure this was Sugar Reef. Kardomah.
Isn't there one down here?
I think there was one down here called Bayswater Brasserie. Studebaker's used to be across the road, and it actually also became Hugo's nightclub for many years. So some of the bands that I remember at the Kardomah were Screaming Jets, they played there a lot, and the Candy Harlots, they were there like nearly every week from memory. Bands like Kings of the Sun, the Bombers, Roxas. Apparently Mick Jagger even came up on stage and did a set back in 1988, I think, when he was in Sydney. And I recall the members from the Black Crows one night after their concert. I remember going there with my brother, and Yeah, we actually met them. That was a highlight because we were huge fans of the Black Crows.
I don't remember a thing. I wasn't there. It wasn't me. I think the only time I ever went, I think a few times, Kardomah Cafe, and the classic story of the 90s was I went up to Chris Robinson and I said, are you a raven or an angel? What a dickhead. And I think I distinctly remember he said, no, I'm a druid.
That's right.
Remember?
Black Crows.
And then, I don't know what I did. I just went, oh yeah, and I walked off. What a dickhead.
I do remember Keith Urban did support the Poor Boys.
Thanks, mate.
Oops. So there's some classic King's Cross characters hanging around. Knew that'd happen eventually. So yeah, apparently Keith Urban supported the Poor Boys one time at
Keith Urban.
Yeah, Keith Urban, country superstar, Aussie superstar.
He wasn't around then.
No, he wasn't well known. That's why he supported the Poor Boys, because the Poor Boys were a local. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Poor Boys were sort of starting to get really popular in Sydney. They came from Darwin. Skeenie's a powerhouse. He's amazing vocals. The band are awesome rock and roll band. It was kind of where a lot of, you know, musicians used to come. Even after concerts, after a gig, you'd kind of, it'd be late and you'd just turn up, and it didn't matter what time it was always open. It felt like it was open 24 hours. Sometimes it was packed, sometimes it wasn't. I think the first time the Screaming Jets played there in 1989 was the first time I actually saw them. So yeah, that's a good memory for me. And just hanging out with my friends, Karen, Sally and Gina and Lydia, Daryl, Jelly, Tony, hanging out at these venues. It was great. Great fun. A really good, really good era of rock and roll. Loved it. Great times. Springfields or the old Manzil Room.
Springfields?
Yeah, I always got lost trying to find the place, and yeah.
It's not heavy metal though.
Just hard rock. Yeah, hard rock, rock and roll. It's where a lot of musicians went to after their concerts, and famous alleyways of King's Cross. Trying to find Springfields. And typically on Lost, some things never change. All right, now I've got, here it is. No, and that's why it took me forever to actually get there. All right, I've got to go down this street and then towards Victoria Street, apparently. Let's go.
Are you lost?
Yes, but I think I'm found.
All right.
Here it is here. There it is. There it is there. To Springfield Avenue, so.
Springfield was actually on Springfield Lane.
Yeah, it was. Well, Springfield Avenue, I think.
Yeah.
Here it is.
This is it, is it?
I think, hang on. I think this is it. I remember this area here. There was another place next door called the Tunnel.
Where are you going?
I'm just trying to remember whether it was this one or that one.
Show me.
15 Springfield Avenue. So it used to be an apartment block called Little House.
That's not it then.
Oh, hang on. Oh! Hang on. Oh man, it was so long ago. I think, well, there was a hotel here. So the Manzil Room actually started in the late 70s by a guy called Joe, an Englishman. It sort of was also known as the Mandrax or the Mongrel Room. And 2SM even made a jingle about it. You can kind of find that on YouTube somewhere. some of the bands that used to play when it was the Manzil Room, people like Doug Williams, Moving Pictures, Kevin Borich, Rene Gaya, Swanee, Tommy and Phil Emanuel played there, Matt Finish, Paul Kelly. It then closed down for a couple of years and it became known as Springfields or Springers. Some people called it the Lounge. And the funny thing about Springfields was that the support band came on at midnight and the main band came on at 2. So some of the famous people that actually went to the Manzil Room or Springfields later were people like Michael Hutchins. He apparently walked in there with Rob Lowe one time. Angus Young apparently was in there once and he jammed with the Poor Boys. David Bowie apparently was a regular. Robert Smith was there, Bon Jovi, Stray Cats. I actually remember standing at the bar and one of the guys from Alice in Chains was standing next to me. There were all kinds of people, all kinds of people. I remember Penthouse Pets at the bar, standing at the bar. Musicians would just stroll in with their sunglasses on after a gig. It was just a place to be. It was dark. The carpet was super sticky. The toilets, yeah, tiny. Tiny stage, really, really small stage. The music was super loud. And it was just a place where everybody just kind of hung out till all hours. You'd walk out and the sun was, you know, rising. I don't know, in my experience, it lasted for about 3-4 years. So, yeah. All right, stop for now.
Jerry.
Oh, I want to say Slash and Skid Row after Guns N' Roses.
You said it and you're on camera.
Oh, no, stop it. Slash and members of Skid Row apparently also turned up one night after the Guns N' Roses concert in Sydney back in 92, I think it was. And what else? Rose Tattoo actually sung a song called Manzil Madness. And I guess it was a period of about 3-4 years where it just was really thriving. It was a great place to be. Did I say Judge Mercy and Horsehead and all that?
You just did.
Oh.
You just said it.
The Angels apparently played there under a different name, and sometimes that's what they do. Before they'd go and do their live gigs, they'd kind of do a little preview and go under a different name.
Is that Jerry or what?
Honestly, it looks exactly like Jerry. Shauna Jensen played there on Sundays.
Who?
Shauna Jensen, she was a blues singer. And apparently a lot of people used to also, when it was a Manzil Room, go in there and play backgammon. So some people didn't even really seem...
You're talking about the 1950s.
No, it wasn't open in the 50s. No, it was late 70s. So when it was the Manzil Room in the late 70s, that was like a different kind of era. A lot of people would actually even just go in there and play backgammon and just drink. I think Barron's is around the corner. Barron's was just a bar that was sort of not too far from here, and that was open all hours as well. So I remember heading in there a few times. And you'd often go there after a concert. So I remember going to see gigs out in the suburbs and then heading into Springfields to sort of finish off the evening. So that's a lot of my memory. Thanks guys for watching. This was certainly a trip down memory lane. And yeah, see you later from me and a very, very look-alike Jerry.
Jerry.
Manzil Room, King's Cross, for the best live music in town.